Good afternoon. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Ho Hua Chew, as the outstanding advocate of our time. Ho Chew.
Can you hold this? You might be better. Yeah. Okay, great.
Ho Chew is one of the most tireless advocates of nature conservation in Singapore. Joining the Nature Society in 1971, he became an active member from the mid-80s. He was part of the team that developed and wrote the Society's proposal for the conservation area of birds and traditional agriculture at Sungai Buloh. In the early 1990s, he played a major role in the formulation of the Society's Master Plan for Nature and in the campaigns for a bird conservation area at Sungai Sinoko and the Cranji Marshes Park. He had a hand in many other conservation products. His advocacy work has extended far beyond the surveys and the writing of conservation proposals and feedback to the government on concepts, master, and localised plans. He has held countless groups of people. He's led countless groups of people, members of the public, nature society members, business executives, government officials, on walks to enjoy nature and to understand the importance of conservation. I too have readily taken the lead in the difficult advocacy campaigns where the official thinking has to be challenged and the policy decisions amended. His commitment to the cause and unflagging efforts over the past three decades have inspired and empowered not just fellow activists and advocates, but countless nature lovers and ordinary Singaporeans.
Thank you.
I'm in the Nature Society. I became active with them around 1985 when I joined the bird group, and I've been working for the society as volunteer in the conservation front for a long time, for at least a couple of decades. And of course, we have achieved quite a bit over the past decade. One of it is quite well known, that is the Sungai Buloh wetland reserve. That was done in the 80s. And then you have also our defense of the nature reserve area at both years, where there was a plan by the government have a golf course. And of course, what we are trying to do is to secure a stronger conservation protection for some of these areas that we have recommended and that have been designated in the green plan as nature areas. And one of these is the Cranji Marshes. Now, we have actually put forward a proposal for its conservation in the late 80s, but there was a lack of response. Then we, in the 1990s, we update our biodata, the bird life survey. After the proposal was put forward, we hear of a development plan for that area. Like, for example, the most threatening was the Cranji Sanctuary Golf Course. We are not able to sort of avert the development, but at least we are able to save a part of the area, a buffer for the golf course. But we weren't satisfied when the URA declared it the Marshes Park, which is an upgrade from the status of the nature area. So there was a period of about 7-8 years where the area was under our adoption program. So we promoted it to the schools, to the public, to the corporate body, getting involved. We have a stake in the area, doing maintenance work, public law, administration, and whatnot, to take care of that area. And it was quite a success. I think because of our effort there, the authorities, URA and NPAR, decided to sort of get more involved. Recently, the park is opened, officially opened in the Cranji Marshes Park, 2016. It's more than 20 years. For the example I've given, visiting Cranji Marshes Park and the Bidadari Nature Park, persistent pays off. The obdurate, or maybe you know, pace off, you see, impatient, and never to give up. As long as the area or part of the area is still intact, it is still worth, you know, struggling and pushing on to the objective. But the important thing is to be polite with the authorities and to engage them with reasonable data collected. And to our counterparts in the civil service, such a new generation, I would like to appeal to you all that we have to give our advocates, especially among the younger generation, a chance to air their views, to argue, and to listen to them. As I see now, I think a lot of the young people, they tend to say that, well, it's no use. Once they have made up their mind or have exhibited their plan, there is no way you can change the mind. But as I see from years of experience in our engagement with the authorities, this is not so, especially in the case of Bidadari and so on. So I appeal to you, I mean, in the case of Bidadari, the thank you things that they have sort of gained a lot from their engagement with us. And so I think that should be the way forward, you know.
Invite Connie to present this award, and I think it's so fitting that his last message was be persistent, don't give up. How can you help him? You get to carry. Help me take this so he can make his speech. Thank you.
Oh, wow. I am really surprised and highly honored to be given the award. Sorry about giving you all the EWC3 committee a hard time to come up with a new category of the award, but I'm really highly honored. Well, I'd like to thank the society for giving me the support. In particular, I just want to name some names because I can't put them out of my mind. All these years from the society, people like Sean Lam, our current president. Past President came in, Secretary Evelyn Lim Eng, past Secretary, and then Margie Hall, Kok Peng, the current Chairman of the Constituent Committee, as well as Paul, for boldly putting in the nomination to the society. Well, I mean, I wouldn't be so active if not for joining the bird group of the Nature Society in the mid-80s. I was a sleeping member from 71 to the mid-80s. So when I joined the group, I became active because I think I find that a unique group of people, amateur, right? They don't have any degree, biological sciences, and they come from all walks of life, for giving me the support and for inspiring me, right, to get to know our countryside, the Singapore countryside, the bird life, and so on. Here you have people like Clive Brickhead, big Clive Brickhead, the leaders of the bird group like Kim Kien, Kim Seng, people like Sutari, current leaders like Alan Aoyang, and Min Chong, and also, you know, former members of the bird group like Subharaj, for giving me the kamaradiri and also the support for doing the groundwork and get to know the bird life of our countryside here. And of course, thanks to Paul for boldly putting in the nomination on behalf of society. All right. Okay, I would like especially to thank my wife, Kim Chu, right, for being so liberal. for being liberal, giving me the allowance to roam the Singapore bush for birds, even during weekends and so on, for a long, long time, for decades. All right. So, well, come to think of it, I say, it's hard for me to retire, man, from advocacy work. it gave me a kick, so I feel that, wow, it's tough now to retire. But I can say that this new category, advocacy over time, I think will definitely inject to young advocates, activists, to push on and on until they become to the age when you become like me. All right. I think we become Asian.